G'day, 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 smart person. My name's Dylan. I'm a physicist from the land down under. Grab a coffee, grab a chair, grab a Vegemite sandwich. Look, grab whatever you want. Let's talk some natural philosophy. So today we're going to be watching some more Attack on Titan. The last video is doing pretty well. People are enjoying it, learning some stuff. So let's watch some more. I thought it was pretty interesting, to say the least. It was pretty fun watching people get eaten and all. Now, look, it's pretty intense. So if you haven't seen the first video and if you haven't seen the show, you know, you might want to click away if you're fairly squeamish. But anyway, let's get into it. Let's break down some of the physics of Attack on Titan and see what other cool stuff we can talk about. So I was going to watch more of the show, but too many of you couldn't keep your mouth shut and you spoiled all the secrets in the comments of the last video. And now I know the walls weren't actually built by the humans, so my discussion was completely pointless. And all the people saying I'm Erwin's father, not sure I get the joke, so someone might have to explain it in the comments. Is it that I look like him, or is there some inside joke that I'm missing? Some people were challenging me about the 3D maneuvering gear in the comments. So to put that one to rest, I didn't really explain why you'd be fainting. So if you were pulling many Gs as you get launched in all these directions and multiple axes up, down, diagonally, you'd be pulling many, many, many Gs. And the reason why you faint is because that the blood can't get to your brain, because your blood is obviously used to Earth's gravity. And you know, it can usually get to your brain. But as you experience a higher level of blood, it can't get to your brain and you faint. So, and that happens at about 9 Gs. A normal person at about 5 Gs will faint, but you can get somewhat used to the lower level of blood supply to the brain, as fighter pilots do. But for us normal humans, 5 Gs and you're done. So these people using this 3D maneuvering gear are probably pulling many Gs. That's all I'm going to say. I haven't worked it out. I'm sure somebody has out there. So if you know how many Gs, comment down below. But anyway, so yeah, 3D maneuvering gear is dead. It's not feasible. It's not practical. And it's just not going to work. But anyway, let's find some other stuff in the show that we can talk about. More of the very unrealistic maneuvering, 3D maneuvering gear.
敵が力を残す術を持っているなら再び巨人を出現させることもできるかもしれん。Lightning。やはりか。けど。
So I've noticed this when the Titans transform, I mean when the people turn into Titans, there's a huge bolt of lightning. I mean, it looked a little bit different when Eren was transforming. It was like a almost like ball lightning. So let's talk a little bit about lightning, because lightning is really mysterious still. We currently still don't understand lightning all that well, or what even causes it. So maybe we can talk a little bit about normal lightning and a little bit about this ball lightning. So normal lightning, if you didn't know, isn't actually that thick. It's only about a finger width. It's like a couple centimeters. So, but its temperature is about as hot. Well, actually it's about 30,000 degrees Celsius. So that's hotter than the surface of the sun. So stay away from lightning. So what triggers lightning? These electrical bolts from the skies. Well, you have electrical charge building up in clouds and you've got the opposite charge in the ground. So that creates electrical attraction. But what causes these bolts, you know, to occur at any given time at any particular location compared to, you know, a completely identical, you know, another point in time and another location? What It's not clear. We don't know why lightning occurs at a particular time and a particular location. Over the past 20 years, there's actually been a few papers published suggesting that maybe cosmic rays are triggering lightning. And cosmic rays are just high energy protons and atomic nuclei that are traveling at nearly the speed of light. And they come from the sun, other stars, and sort of things like that. So you get these high energy particles, you know, hitting the atmosphere, and they're interacting with clouds, and that causes these high energy collisions cause some sort of triggering of lightning. But there's really no proof of these ideas currently, but it's an interesting idea. Another really cool thing to consider is that these lightning bolts may actually be triggering high energy particles. And what I mean by that is that we've detected some X-rays from lightning bolts. And further, we may have actually detected gamma rays coming from lightning bolts, which means that lightning might be generating antimatter. How cool is that? Because antimatter and normal matter annihilates when antimatter pops into existence. And when they annihilate, this is what creates flashes of gamma rays. And we actually detected these gamma ray flashes coming from powerful thunderstorms from satellites that are normally used for astronomical stuff. And to finish off this massive tangent about lightning, I wanted to tell this little story that I found super fascinating. So in the 18th century, it was believed that ringing church bells actually repelled lightning. And a lot of the church bells at this time actually had the inscription Fulgura Frango, which meaned I chase lightning. So during a big thunderstorm, these bell boys would run up to the bell tower, they'd ring the bells, and that's probably the worst place you could be in a lightning storm. So as you can imagine, a lot of people died, and I think it was between 1753 and 1786. It was something like 103 people got killed by lightning strikes. So yeah, they then banned that whole sort of method of ringing bells during storms. But anyway, I thought that was an interesting story. So I've changed my mind. I actually might save the ball lightning discussion and some cool facts about it for the next video, in case we do another one on Attack on Titan. And maybe that relates to, you know, I've noticed there's different Titans, right? And so when Eren transforms, you know, it looks like ball lightning, whereas others, it seems like, you know, a bolt of lightning. So maybe that has something to do with something. I know there's a lot of people writing down in the comments of videos about theories of these anime shows, and some people seem to find some of the stuff I say interesting and relevant for unraveling some of the mysteries of the show. So who knows, maybe there's something to that as well. So yeah, make sure you subscribe and stick around, and we'll talk about ball lightning in the next one. That's a big rock.
Erenが勝ったんだ! 今、自分の責任を果たそうとしている! あとは、エレンを扉まで援護すれば! 僕らの勝ちだ!
<笑>死守せよ! 我々の命と引き換えにしてでも!
So could he carry such a big rock? Who knows? But another thing that I should point out is the leg width of, say, Eren's Titan. Well, it should be a lot wider, because as you get larger, there's a lot more pressure on you, and it increases quite a lot the bigger you get. So it doesn't make a lot of sense for Eren's Titan or these Titans in general for their legs to be, you know, the same sort of scale as a normal human, the same ratio. And so, I mean, take an elephant for example and a deer. An elephant's legs are very wide, and the bigger you get, the width of these legs would have to increase to support the pressure. So it doesn't make a lot of sense, say for Eren's Titan to have, you know, skinny little legs and being so huge. But anyway, looking into that too far. The rock, yeah, probably, but it looks pretty huge. Armin's probably my favorite. Who's your favorite? Leave a comment down below.
So that path is all one point of view. つまりそれが始祖の巨人だ。全てのユミルの民はその座標へとつながっている。始祖ユミルの正体は一体何なんだ?
Okay, that's pretty interesting. So this coordinate thing. Not really sure there's anything that I can connect to reality and physics. Apart from Wi-Fi and invisible lasers in the air. I have watched a little bit of the show and it is pretty wacky. I mean, I'm really enjoying it. It's cool. But some of the answers to some of the questions that people have about the show are pretty out there. So have you ever thought about whether or not it's possible to transfer consciousness to, say, a computer or the cloud? Well, imagine that it is. So maybe what this coordinate and these paths are is simply, you know, consciousness, some sort of consciousness that's in the cloud. And from the previous era of humans, like it's been explained in the show. So maybe that's what's going on. You know, they mentioned that memories are contained within these paths and the coordinates. So maybe that's what's going on. And this, the founding Titan is this consciousness in the cloud. So who knows? I mean, I certainly think consciousness is nothing but atoms and, you know, physics-y stuff going on in the brain. And I think we'll be able to replicate that using computers, to be honest. So some sort of artificial, you know, intelligence, I think, is not too far away. So maybe uploading consciousness to a computer isn't all that far away. So maybe something like this coordinate or these paths aren't too far off, you know, something in the far future, some sort of technology, but I think we're reaching. So anyway, all right, so that'll do for this video. I couldn't really find anything else to talk about that was interesting. So I think we'll just keep this video short. And if you haven't already, please apply some time derivative of momentum onto that subscribe button. And I'll see you guys next time. Catch ya.